Hi, in this video I want to have a look at the influencer trap event in State of Survival. We're about to play it. It will still take a couple of minutes. Our leader, Banana Joe, is about to announce or ask who wants to do the rallies. Normally we set it up with two or three waves of rallies. In each wave, three or four rally leaders. This way, the people not rally leaders, they can hit the influencer trap many times. Maybe a bit about the event itself. So you have this alliance building. Every 2 days is a cooldown, and then you can open it, and there's a monster that you should do damage to with an alliance with rallies. And you should in a half an hour do enough damage to kill it. Then you get the victory rewards, the damage rewards. Anybody doing any damage gets based on the amount of damage they do. If you donate something, you need to donate at least 100 as an alliance within those 2 days. You can you at least get a victory rewards if the alliance wins. So Welle, that means like wave. This is a German alliance. I'm not German myself, but I'm Dutch, and most of it I understand. So I have to, at least have to pay some attention. Normally Jack, that's me, Diamond Jack. So I'm in the second wave. I think it's only two waves. Okay, with 2.5 minutes. Maybe that's based, I don't know exactly how he determines that. Often we do three waves with three rally leaders, sometimes two waves with two rally leaders. Maybe that's based on the amount of people that are online. Maybe this is more suitable at the moment. I think if you have enough, better to do three waves. In this case, we only do two. So I have to, I don't have to pay that much attention. Just when 2.5 minutes, it's not opened yet, but when 2.5 minutes is down, I will set my rally. And then I'm located quite close. I will just keep doing rallies. So I go there, come back, set another rally. And other people jump between the different rallies. What I normally would do is use my massive, or what is it called? The massive march rally, but that is we are going to do reservoir raid shortly after this, and I'm going to keep it for that. What I always do is I switch to the war talent tree. I've already done that, and then set up one of my troop formations. Normally I use the second slot for that to use it for this event. And in that case, I'm not going to use any infantry, because infantry doesn't do much damage. I focus on the hunters, and also have some riders in there, because they don't have enough hunters of the higher tier troops. So that's my preparation. When I'm a rally leader, I'm not going to be the top damage dealer. Sometimes I've been the number one damage dealer. If I wasn't a rally leader, I can just jump between all these different rallies. I'm not going to make a video of this complete event, because it's not that interesting. I just want to show like what is the tactic that we are using. And I think it's a good tactic. The alternative tactic is do not work with waves, but just have, for example, 5-6 people setting rallies and everybody joining those rallies. And then after those rallies are done, they set another rally. So not have these different waves. And in that case, the drawback of that is that the people joining the rallies only do one time damage in every 5+ minutes. And in the tactic we use with two waves or even three waves gives enough time for people to join a rally in every wave. So people not, if you do three waves, people not being the rally leaders, they can do damage three times. So that is really quite attractive. I'm going to start setting the rally a bit earlier, partly because it just takes a few clicks before you're done, but also not on the fastest connection, and wouldn't be nice if it is hanging, so to say. So I start the process now. So choose rally, 5 minutes, then take the second slot. Normally, because it is unbalanced the first time, I get this. So that's it, and now I just keep doing it like that. Maybe we just wait until the first wave hits, just to see what kind of damage we are doing. Yeah, you can choose the difficulty level of the influencer that you open. The R4 and R5 can open the influencer trap. So ideally you would like to go for a higher and higher one each time you beat the highest one. A higher level is unlocked that you can use the next time. Sometimes when you're not on with so many people, you don't choose the highest necessarily, because you want the victory. You want to have the victory in the end. I feel like the damage rewards are more interesting than the victory rewards, so it doesn't really matter whether you beat or not. Whether you succeed or not as an alliance, those damage rewards give you important ingredients that allow you to make better hero gear. So you get the hero gear parts, and you get design fragments. You need a lot of those, unfortunately, but you do get some design fragments to unlock a better gear level. Could mean you have to play, I think, like maybe half a year, 150 days. If you play every 2 days and you get two of these fragments each time, then it takes you, you need 150 fragments, or it takes you a very long time to get there. If you score, I think the number one damage dealer can get a reward for up to 5 of those Hero Gear design parts. So I hope they introduce some other ways to get it as well, because this way it's going to take a very long time. So the first wave here, about 25 minutes in, so the first wave is about to depart. And we can see kind of damage we are dealing. I don't know. It feels like it's hard with only two waves to make enough damage. I have to ask him sometime what his reasoning is, because it seems two waves with four people, then you have more people per wave, but the people make less, can do less rallies during a wave, can join less rallies during a wave. So it doesn't seem, on the one hand you think, oh, there must be more, on the other hand you feel like, oh, maybe there are less people online. So I would prefer the three waves of three rally leaders, ideally even three waves of four rally leaders if you have enough people on. The idea is that during every wave, everybody online should be able to join a rally. Okay, hey, this was it. I'm not going to make the video too long. I hope you get the idea and understand how this benefits. It's important that you make things clear in advance, like when are we going to do the influencer traps. Selecting a fixed time and do it every 2 days is good. The nice thing is the cooldown is not really 2 days. I think it's 2 days minus 2 hours or something. So even if you are a bit late, you can always start the next one again on the same time in 2 days. So you don't have to kind of shift it through and through, because you're going to be a little bit later. And also kind of coordinate it well, who is going to be the rally leaders, and you need to make appointment. If someone for whatever reason misses his rally time, he should just wait out and the next 5 minutes later set up a rally again, not shift 1 or 2 minutes and put his rally there, because that is then the concept of the waves doesn't work anymore, and you will have one wave where not everybody can get into a rally. So that is something to keep in mind. Hey, this was it. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or any comments, that's always much appreciated.